To see and behold Jesus, we need to close our sight to other objects that blind and blinker our vision. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, there are two little whiles in today's gospel. The first refers to the time between the moment Jesus spoke to the apostles and his death on the cross. The second to the time between his resurrection and the ascension when he returns to his Father. In the first little while, the apostles with bodily eyes see Jesus in his physical body. In the second instance, they will behold his glorified body with spiritual vision. Whether in the first or second little while, to see and behold Jesus, we need to close our sight to other objects that blind and blinker our vision. This is being illustrated by John chapter 15, verse 5, which says, "I am the vine and you are the branches." Through this statement, Jesus will no longer be present physically in the midst of us, but still, we are called to remain united to him in a new way, to bear fruit in our lives. So, dear brothers and sisters, let me ask a question. If we are not united to the Lord, what will happen to us? Look at these fingers. If we cut or separate the one finger from the rest of the fingers, will it have a life in it? No. In the same way, Jesus says in the Gospel of St. John, chapter 15, verse 6, "Whoever does not abide in me is thrown away like a branch and withers. Such branches are gathered and thrown into the fire and burned." Then how can we unite with the Lord? I would like to share with you three main points which will help us to unite ourselves with the Lord. The first point is prayer, second, Word of God, and third, Eucharist. Coming to the first point, prayer. Prayer helps us to create relationship between us and to God, because only through relationship we can be united to the Lord. And this relationship is the fruit of our prayer life. Second, Word of God. St. Jerome says, "Ignorance of Scripture is the ignorance of Christ." We come to know God's mighty deeds only through reading the Scripture, which will help us to unite ourselves with the Lord. And the third and the last point, that is Eucharist. Eucharist is the source and summit of our life. We find the presence of joy in it. It is imperishable bread, not like that of Old Testament manna, but the living bread, which came down from heaven, to give life in abundance, and which will last forever. So, dear brothers and sisters, let us practice these in our life, so that we may be able to see Jesus not only with our physical eyes, but also with our spiritual eyes. Amen.